Okay guys, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Mana dia orang? Alright, we go through to the state of matter 5.1 guys. The practice question number 1 . So, for the part A, so I take one of your friends paying to be marked by me. And then please the other please pay attention All right guys. So for the question number A, a sample of gas occupy a volume of 10 liter at the pressure of 2 atm, what would be the pressure of the gas if is it allowed to expand in a 50 liter container at the same temperature? All right. So okay, the part A, given the temperature is constant, right? So yeah, correct. You will use P1 V1 equal to P2 V2. Yeah. So by using those equation, just substitute all the value given. 2 atm, 10 liter and 50 liter, right? And then the pressure we will manage to get this answer. Yeah, so the answer is correct, 0.4 atm, right? And then for the part B, a sample of gas occupy 100 ml at 25 degrees Celsius. So what volume would the gas occupy at 32 degrees Celsius if the pressure remain constant? Right, so this one, which one is it, constant, the pressure, right? Okay, so the pressure is constant, so you read like this, V1 divided by T1 equal to V2 divided by T2, right? So okay, give the question first, make sure the pressure is constant, right? All right, and then you all substitute the value given, 100 ml, and then the temperature. Yeah guys, please do remember, if you talk about the temperature in the gas law, you should convert it to Kelvin, right? All right, so convert to Kelvin. Yeah, correct. And then I wanted to find it the volume number 2, right? So the answer will be 102.35 mil. yeah, the answer is correct. Okay, and then go to the next one, the last question for the practice question number 1. So the question is determine the volume of the hydrogen gas obtained from the reaction of 6.50 gram of zinc and an excess of dilute sulfuric acid at STP. STP stands for the standard temperature pressure, guys. When the pressure and also the temperature are kept constant. All right. So the firstly, I set up the equation. Okay. So this one, for the zinc in solid form, please take solid and then H2SO4 in aqueous phase, aqueous, AQ. Alright, so zinc sulfate will be aqueous also, and then the hydrogen will be the gas, right? Okay, so this one is your AQ. Sorry guys. Okay, and then the hydrogen is in the gas phase. All right. Okay. And then what is it given in your question? 6.5 gram of zinc. So from the equation, our first stoichiometry will be 1 mole of the zinc will produce 1 mole of hydrogen gas, right? So yeah, the equation is the stoichiometry is correct, and then you calculate the mole for the zinc. So the mole for the zinc, the AR for the zinc is 65 something, guys. So not 30, this one is wrong, wrong, the AR for the zinc is 65.65 lah, 65.37, 65.4. Okay lah, so I take 65. So your mole for the zinc is 66.5 divided by 65, so the answer is wrong here, not 0.22 mole, but yeah, you will manage to get 0.1 mole of zinc. Mole, that is the mole for the zinc, guys. All right. So your next stoichiometry will be here also 0.1 lah. Okay, 0.1 lah, not 0.22 lah, 0.1 lah. Okay, paying. The calculation for the mole is incorrect, so please very careful why you all do the calculation, especially for the mole. Please make sure the is it you take the proton number or you take the AR. So use the mass. So see, okay, 0.1, okay. Sorry guys. Alright, so 0.1 mole of zinc will produce this one also 0.1 lah. Alright, so incorrect over there. So this one is correct, 0.1 mole of hydrogen gas. Alright, and at STP, right? So as STP, where is it? Okay, so at STP we know that. Okay, so I put it here, guys. So you all know that one mole is consists of at STP, standard temperature pressure is consists of 22.4 dm cube, right? Can occupy 22.4 dm cube, right? So if 0.1 mole can occupy 2.24 dm cube, so this is the volume of the hydrogen gas. All right, so this one, all right, 2.24. okay, this one is incorrect. Okay guys, okay, we go to the next question. Alright, so question number, practice question number 2. Okay, so A, the density of the gas X is 2.6 gram per liter at 25 degrees Celsius and 101 kilopascal. What is the molecular mass of the gas? Alright, so that is the question number A. And then is it correct? The answer will be 63.61 gram. Okay, almost right. Almost 63.61 gram per mole. Almost right. Almost so correct. All right. So we look at the step in the calculation. All right. Okay. So the ideal gas equation, PV equal to nRT. This equation is valid only for the gas, not for liquid and not for solid. So please beware, all the pressure, the P pressure, pressure of the what? Pressure of the gas, volume of the what? Volume of the gas. It mean volume of the container. And then this one is the mole. The mole for the gas, R is the gas constant, and temperature of the system always in Kelvin. All right, so PV equal to nRT, and then you can substitute. The mole is, of course, I think all is know the formula to calculate the mole, mass over molar mass, right? So substitute this one. All right, correct. Alright, and then And then you reshuffle. Want to find it, the what is it? The molar mass, right? So you want to find it, the MR, yeah. Alright, given the density, mass over volume is the density, right? Given the density, yeah. Yeah. Alright. So you can find it, the pressure given, right? And then one more thing, guys. I need you all to change the unit. Please make sure the unit for the pressure is atm. For the volume, please make sure in liter. Mole is mole. R is the gas constant. Use this one. R equal to 0.08206 or 821. So the unit will be liter atm per mole per Kelvin, right? So if you look at the unit for the R constant, that is liter. So please make sure your volume is in liter, atm. Please make sure your pressure in atm, right? And then mole is mole, and then the Kelvin. Please make sure you convert it, your the degree Celsius to Kelvin, right? Okay, guys. And then okay, this one, the conversion from kilopascal to atm, yeah, paying managed to get 0.9967 atm, right? And then just insert the data, all right, 0.9967 atm. ATM, and then how about this one? This one is the R constant. This one, liter ATM per mole per Kelvin. And then your temperature, make sure you convert it to Kelvin. And then this one is, what is it? This one is the molar. The density, right? The density 2.6. Okay, all right. So you do the calculation, yeah, you will manage to get the molar mass. So yeah, this answer is correct. Okay, so we go to the next one, B. When an evacuated glass vessel weighing 134.74 gram was filled with an unknown gas, why? The pressure was found to be 99.3 kilonewton per meter square at 31 degrees Celsius. Why? The mass was 137.28 gram. The glass vessel was then filled completely with water, and the mass was 1067.9 gram. By using the ideal gas equation, determine the molar mass of the gas, why? Okay, so the answer will be, the answer? 69.33 gram per mole. So your answer, where is it, your answer? Oh, this one, incorrect. Okay. So, for the B, I, Okay, pause guys. I continue later. Okay guys, I will continue here about the question number practice question number 2, question number B. Alright. So find the mass for the gas X. So the mass for the gas X equal to 137.28 minus 134.74. Yeah, you will manage to get 2.54 gram of the mass of the gas, right? And then the mass for the water, the mass for the water H2O equal to 1067.90 minus 134.74. Now you manage to get 933.316 gram, guys. All right. Okay, so that is the first step. Okay, so the second step, you must find it the volume for the gas X, right? So the volume for the gas X, volume for the gas X equal to, that is volume of the container, volume of the vessels, and it's also equal to volume of water. Remember this guy, you already know about the mass for the water, right? So yeah, the density of the water also, you know, 1 gram per mil, that one, yeah. Supposedly, you all know, you all should know that the density of the water is 1.0 gram per mil. And then from here, you also know the mass for the water, right? So you can see that the volume of the water equal to the mass for the water is 900. Before this, what is it? Okay, wait up. Alright. Yeah, 933.316 gram, right? Okay, and then okay, so 933.316 gram divided by 1.0 gram per mil, right? So from here you will manage to get 933.316 mil. Okay, so change it to liter. Why? Because when you talk about the PV equal to NRT, always do remember your volume is in liter unit. All right so one of the the careless mistake by the previous student, not change or not convert the volume of the gas to liter. All right so please convert it to liter. So yeah, you will manage to get 0.933 liter. All right so the volume of the gas you manage to get by using this equation, right? Okay, please do remember lah. Volume of the gas X is equal to the volume of the container, is it? Because the gas is occupy space all in the closed container, right? So the volume of the water here given memenuhi ruang. So the volume of the gas is this one, 0.933 liter. Alright, and then we go to the next one. Okay, we need to find it the molar mass. So the molar mass of the gas equal to the density times to the R constant, gas constant, time to T, divided by pressure. And then readjust the formula, so you will manage to get like this: mass times to R times to T divided by V times to P, right? Okay, so substitute all the value. The mass is 2.54 gram. Earlier we have calculated it. 2.54, is it? Yeah, this one, 2.54 gram, the mass of the gas, right? Right, so 2.54 times the R constant 0.0821 or 206, up to you, and then times to temperature 31 degrees Celsius. Please convert it to Kelvin, so you will manage to get times to 304, right? Okay, here times to 304 Kelvin divided by can divide by the volume of the gas, 0.933 liter. Please change it to liter, guys. And then the ATM, where is it? The ATM already convert it or not? Already convert or not yet? Okay, please convert to ATM. Please convert to ATM. Yeah, you will manage to get 0.94 ATM. Okay, and then your final answer will be 69.33 gram per mole. So that is the answer for the part B. Okay, and then we go to the part C. Okay, part C, guys. Okay, part C, a sample of gas A, weighing 40.5 gas, occupying a volume of 50 liter at 25 degrees Celsius and 1.5 atm. Determine the molar mass of gas A. Alright, so the answer will be 4.02 gram per mole. Alright, so for the C, practice question number 2. C, the molar mass equal to the mass times the R constant times to the T divided by PV or VP. So substitute all the given data. The mass is 40.5 gram. 40.5 gram times R constant, of course, 0.0821, right, times to temperature 25 degrees Celsius. Convert it to Kelvin. Yeah, you will manage to get 298 Kelvin. So divide to the volume of the gas given 50 liter. Okay, just insert the data. 15.0 liter times, and then the ATM, where is it? Okay, 1.5. 1.5 ATM. So do the calculation. Okay, please do the calculation, and then yeah, you will manage to get for the Paxi, you will manage to get 4.02 gram per mole. Okay, alright, done. Alright, so the last question for the practice question number 2, the question number D. Alright, okay, what is the volume of the oxygen gas and STP required for the complete combustion of 10.0 liter of C2H4 is what, guys? C H H, oh, double bond, 18. Alright, 18, guys. Alright, 18. Okay, where is it, my eraser? Oh, this one. Okay, so 18, C2H4. Alright, so the for the question number D, so what given? Okay, so set up first the equation, the combustion equation, C2H4 plus excess oxygen, complete combustion excess oxygen, 3 mole of oxygen gas produce 2 mole of carbon dioxide plus 2 mole of water H2O. Alright, so I need to find it the volume of the oxygen. So what data given? 10 liter STP. Okay, so find it first the mole for the 18. So the mole for the C2H4 equal to PV divided by RT. So your pressure, this is the standard temperature pressure. Of course, your pressure will be 1 atm, your volume given over the 10.0 times to 10 divided by R, the R constant, the gas constant 0.0821 times to temperature. Is it given? Oh, standard, right? Then standard temperature 0 degrees Celsius lah, standard. So change it to Kelvin, so you manage to get 273, or I wanted to use 273.15, up to you. But I think better you use 273, guys. Alright, so 273. Yeah, you do the calculation. Yeah, you will manage to get the mole for the 18 is 0.446 mole. Alright, there is the mole for the 18. Alright. And then from the stoichiometry, where is it, the 18? Okay, for the stoichiometry, we can say that 1 mole of 18 consists of, or will react to 3 mole of oxygen gas. Right now you want to find it the volume of the gas, right? Okay, so okay, go to the new page. Okay, from the equation we know that 1 mole of C2H4 consists of or react to 3 mole of oxygen. 3 mole of oxygen. So the mole for the oxygen, for the 18, we managed to get 0.446 mole. Right, so if the mole for the C2H4 is 0.446 4 for 6 mole. So consists of, yeah, you calculate 3 per 1 times 0.446. 4 for 6, yeah, you will manage to get 1.338 mole of oxygen gases, right? Oxygen gases. Okay. So the mole for the oxygen gases you all managed to calculate, right? Okay. And then we go to the next slide. Next whiteboard. So wanted to find it the volume for the oxygen. Volume for the oxygen equal to okay, wait. PV equal to nRT. Okay, so V equal to nRT divided by P. Alright, so the mole for the oxygen gas 1.338 mole, right? And then the R constant 0.0821, alright. And then the temperature 273, right? Okay, times 6 to 273. So divided to pressure. Where is the pressure? Okay, standard. So 1 atm. So you all calculate the value for the volume of the oxygen gas, blah blah blah. You press your calculator. Yeah, you will manage to get 29.97 liter. So there is your the volume of the oxygen at STP. All right, done. Volume for the oxygen at STP. That one, 29.97 liter. Okay guys, for the next question I will continue later. Okay guys, bye.